When we discussed spin, I mentioned that memory management and CPU management are core services that any operating system has to provide. And we discussed how spin had its own way of dealing with those core services. We will do the same analysis for Exokernel as to how it does memory management and CPU scheduling. First, memory management. Specifically, let's see how Exokernel will handle a page fault incurred by a library operating system. So in this picture that I'm showing you, here is an application thread running, and maybe this application thread belongs to a specific library operating system. And so long as this application thread is doing normal memory accesses, where all its virtual addresses have been mapped to physical page frames, the thread is executing at hardware speeds on the CPU. Life is good. But life may not be always good, because this thread may incur a page fault. And when it incurs a page fault, the page fault is first fielded by Exokernel. Exokernel knows which library operating system is currently executing on the CPU. It has no knowledge of processes within a library operating system. All it knows is that this library operating system is doing something on the CPU, and it knows that there is a page fault incurred, and it can kick it up to the library operating system through a registered handler. And we will talk about how these handlers are known to Exokernel later on. Right now, I just want to give you the roadmap of how a page fault is handled in Exokernel, because the library operating system knows about processes, whereas Exokernel has no knowledge about that, and it services the page fault. And servicing the page fault may involve requesting Exokernel for a page frame to host the specific page that is missing. And if it does that, as we detailed before, that will involve the library asking Exokernel for a page frame and Exokernel creating a binding for a page frame and returning an encrypted key for the page frame. Assume for the moment that the library operating system has page frames already with it, and all that it is doing at this point is, in servicing the page fault, it establishes a mapping between the virtual page that was missing and the page frame that contains the contents of that virtual page. Once it does that, that mapping between the virtual page and the frame that it corresponds to has to be presented to the Exokernel. So the library presents that mapping to Exokernel along with the TLB entry where it wants this mapping to be placed in the hardware TLB. Remember that when the process runs, the CPU is consulting the hardware TLB to see if there is a valid mapping between the virtual page number and a physical frame so that the CPU can go and access that page. And we got the page fault because such a mapping did not exist. And the whole point of this exercise is for the library operating system to reestablish a mapping. But it cannot do that directly into the TLB. So it presents the mapping to Exokernel along with the encrypted key that represents the capability that the library operating system has to a specific TLB entry where it wants this to be placed. Exokernel will validate the encrypted key presented by the library operating system, and assuming all is good, it will go ahead and install the mapping in the hardware TLB. And this is a privileged operation, meaning that it can be done only in the kernel mode of the processor. That's the reason that you have this red line between the library operating system that runs at the non-privileged level and Exokernel that runs at the privileged level to do certain operations such as installing an entry into the TLB. And once the entry has been installed in the TLB, if the library operating system is once again scheduled on the processor and if the same process is run by the library operating system, when it generates the same virtual address, we're going to find a valid mapping and life will be good.